good times when you're living, when everything's working, 1987, we'd play like 80 shows in 90 days. That ain't easy. You gotta be young to do that. And I remember, and we're always staying in Motel 6s, always the Motel 6s. Oh my God, four people in a Motel 6 room. Waking up one morning in Austin, Texas, in a Motel 6, that was this, one of those single Motel 6s with one big double bed. And I looked next to me and there was this huge girl next to me. It was a huge girl. And I didn't really remember what had happened, and the whole room was filled with Budweiser bottles. And I just saw this long hair, and I had my clothes on though, so I felt like, well, I don't know what happened here. And I stood up, and then the person in the bed next to me turned over, and it was Gibby Haynes from the Butthole Surfers. For some reason, I felt relieved that this huge, tall person was him. And he said, "Bibbidi!" That's what he used to call me. And I said, "What are we doing? Where are we? What's going on?" And he goes, "I don't know." And he got up, and he started doing what was very popular in those days, which is going through the beer bottles to find which ones still had beer in them and pouring them in a glass to make sure there wasn't cigarette butts in them, and then finding a good way to start the morning. And then, you know, we're out on some highway somewhere outside of Austin, and I opened the door, and it's like, and I was like, "Oh my God, where's a liquor store?" And he's like, "I got a car." And I hadn't remembered what had happened the last 24 hours, but I was glad he had a car, and we went to a liquor store and got some beer, and went and had breakfast, steak and eggs, Bibbidi, steak and eggs. And that was a golden time.